I'm a molecular biologist and geneticist, and I chose to come to the State Department because I felt that it was very important for science to inform our policy decisions, whether they're about healthcare, climate change, food, including genetically modified food modified by molecular techniques. I think these are really important issues going forward if we are to continue improving our healthcare, monitoring diseases and addressing them, developing energy efficient and non-polluting, non-CO2 producing ways of running our economy, powering our economy, and growing the food that we all depend on. My research has been on the molecular genetic modification, what people now call GMOs. These techniques have been developed over the past 40 years about, and they're some of the best ways that we have of improving the ability of crop plants to withstand climate change, to protect themselves from attack by insects and diseases. And I'm very enthusiastic about them. The safety record of GM crops is quite astonishing. That is, we have been growing GM crops now for more than a dozen years. And despite all of the bad press they've gotten, their track record is, at the moment, totally safe. That is, nobody has even attributed a headache to genetically modified food. And essentially, all of our food supply contains genetically modified foods. Indeed, going back thousands of years, we have developed ways of modifying plants to serve us as food crops. That's older genetic modification. We don't think of it as such today, but it is indeed. Genetically modified crop plants are essentially the same crop plant you started with one or a few genes added. The genes that have been introduced so far, probably the one that is best known, is a little gene from a bacterium that confers resistance to insect attack on the plant. And in fact, although in the popular perception, that's ecologically dangerous. In fact, it's the opposite, because using these insect-resistant plants, farmers have been able to reduce the amount of pesticide they use. And pesticides, in fact, are poisons that kill all the insects in a field, whereas the genetically modified crops can often be grown with very little or no pesticide. And so it's ecologically better. More insects in the field, more birds, better.